And that wasn't about full locks. Even as you get older, you could still rock it and it's literally still be looking like. Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. So today I'm going to give you guys an update on this butterfly locks that I had in my last three videos, and I'll also be telling you guys how long I had it for and basically showing you guys how I'm going to take it down, because I'm taking it down today. I still have my scarf tied on my hair because I thought I was going to go to the gym this morning, so I wanted to jump to the edges, but that gym life, it didn't work for me this morning. So let's start off with the pros of this hair. I love the fact that this hair is a protective style. I had my hair on for 3 weeks. It was just so perfect. I think it's my first time trying a bob hair look, like something this short. So it was definitely a different feel for me. I felt like it was also perfect for the entire end of summer season. You know, when it started getting really, really hot towards the end, it was just so perfect. I didn't really want any hair to be all over my body. So this was just perfect length, perfect size. And it just kept my natural hair all in place. I love the entire bohemian vibes that it's giving, the, you know, the distressed look. It's just so different from what I'm used to. And it's, I don't know, there's this, it just always looks good. And that wasn't about full locks. Even as you get older, you could still rock it and it's literally still be looking like. The only problem might be your scalp. You may be able to see that your scalp is getting loose. Aside from that, the body of the hair still always looks like, you know, this is the style that you're rocking for now. That kind of thing. When it comes to installation of this hairstyle, you guys remember the issue I had with the passion twist? The same free tress water wave hair was the exact same hair that I used. And one thing that I still have problems with was the was the separating of the hair. So I had a little bit of tangling on the hair here and there that I had to throw away some of the hair that I did end up using because they had tangled up. And then one thing I'll also tell you guys is when you're installing this hair, you want to make sure that the roots, you know, when you're doing like the 3 to 4 tight wraps around the roots of this hair, you want to make sure that you're doing it properly. Like, let it be secure. Let the extension stay secure to your natural hair, because there's a tendency of it getting loose at the roots of your hair very fast because of the texture of the hair. It is free dress water weave, so it's kind of like slippery. So yeah, it easily loosens at the roots if you don't tie it down properly. And then that question I got about this hair is this heavy? I wouldn't say it's heavy, but it feels like I'm carrying something on my head. And then considering the fact that I'm very used to jumbo hairstyle, like really, really jumbo, my box braids and my jumbo twist, they're usually like maximum 25. I don't go beyond 25. This is one of the very few times that I have this much hair on my head. This one was about 52 strands of locks, so I have 52 strands of locks on my head. When it comes to sleeping, my sleeping routine is basically the exact same thing. I normally put a satin head wrap to hold down the entire hair with my edges, so my edges just stays in place. Also, if you didn't know, satin head wrap and silk head wrap, they don't strip your natural hair of moisture, so it's always advisable to stick to satin or silk head wrap compared to cotton, just because they tend to, you know, allow moisture to just stay where it's supposed to stay. So I normally use the satin head wrap, just hold it together, and then I go over top of my entire head using a hair bonnet, just so everything can be tucked in and not all over my body, you know what I mean? Exactly. I have very few cons. The first one I would say is, as it gets older, this hair starts to snag. Look at that. Exactly. It starts to snag, which honestly, I'm not even surprised. I was expecting that to happen because first of all, this is synthetic hair and we have the entire butterfly situation going on right here on the body. So of course, all this extra hair, when they start to get old, they start to mat against each other, and that's what results in the snagging. It's just what you sort of expect with synthetic hair. Except if you're using human hair for this hairstyle, then maybe you could avoid that. But that's just something that, yeah, we just have to deal with. And then the other con I experienced with this hair is the fact that my hair will literally just come out of the locks. Let me show you guys one. Okay, so this one right here. See this one? That's my natural hair. That's the braid. It literally just comes out of this locks. It doesn't unravel, it just comes off. If it unraveled, I feel like I would have been able to just go ahead to wrap it back. But mine didn't unravel at all. Like, nothing here unraveled. I just had about 2 to 3 strands of this locks that just separated out of my natural hair. My natural hair just came out poking. But then again, I don't know if it's as a result of the extension, that's the free dress water wave hair, because my friend who did this hairstyle actually had the exact same problem when she used the free trace water wave hair, but when she used like a different curly extension to the hairstyle again, she did not have that problem. So I don't know if it's from the free trace water wave hair, or it could just be that my natural hair and this extension are just not marrying each other. They just decided that they want to separate, or it could be the extension. But if you guys have tried this hairstyle, you guys should let me know down below in the comment section if you actually experienced the exact same problem as I did. I really want to know if the problem is from my hair or myself or how I installed it, or if it's the extension itself. So let me know down below in the comment section if you experienced the exact same problem. I think that's basically it for the entire update about this hair. Also guys, this is basically my first time doing full locks, like manually, like having to wrap the entire locks. So it's also my first time having to take this down, so it's looking like we're going to have to figure this out together. Okay. So the first thing I'm going to go ahead to do right now, go to the root of this hair where I wrapped it like really really secure, kind of like unravel it, and then just go ahead to find my natural hair braid just like so, and then just slowly pull that out. There you go. So that's my natural hair. Now that this is all out in the way, I'm just going to go ahead to use my scissors to cut out the rest of this locks, and then right now I can just go ahead to slide this off my natural hair. Oh, that was actually pretty easy. This is my hair all out. It's looking perfect. Nothing cut, no damage. Yeah, okay, let's go ahead. Okay, I'll just repeat the exact same thing right here to show you guys. So go to the root of this hair, unravel it just like so. Unravel it as much as you can. Then just go ahead to find my natural hair braid. There you go. So that's my natural hair braid all out in the way. Then I just go ahead to use my scissors, cut out this extension, hold my natural hair, and just gradually slide this extension off. Perfect. Okay, so just in case you didn't catch the previous ones that I did, we're just going to go ahead and do this last one together right now. So grab the strand of the lock that you want to take down, go all the way to the roots, slightly unravel, just so the roots of the hair can just be loosened up a little bit. Unravel, then just go ahead to find your natural hair braided strand. It's actually so easy to find because they are completely different textures. I could just see it as well. So now that my natural hair is all out, I just go ahead to cut this extension, and then this just glides out. It took me exactly 30 minutes to take this down. It was really quick and it was so easy. So right now I'm just going to go ahead to take down my natural hair plait. I'll be using this, my peak comb, this one. You can use a regular rat tail comb if you don't have any of this. It will basically work fine as well. You just need something that has a pointy end. You can even use a toothpick. Then just go ahead to start unraveling. As you guys can see, I don't really have that much build up, but if you carry this hairstyle for as long as 1 month or 2 months, you definitely have a little bit more build up than this. So you could just use like your spray bottle of water and then spritz it on your scalp, okay, and then just use it to dissolve the build up, and it will basically be just fine when you just comb through it. And yeah, so that's basically for this entire update and takedown of these butterfly locks. I'm just going to go ahead and take down the rest of my natural hair plait off camera. But I hope this video was helpful. So let me know down below in the comment section if you tried this hairstyle and what are the challenges you face and what is the thing you love most about the hairstyle. I will see you guys in my next video and have a wonderful rest of your week. Bye. She be moving so quick, you never see her coming. She wants to see one now. She and me, A1. Now, so me say.